In today's video, I'm gonna be sharing with you guys how I wake up at 5 a.m., what are the three things that I work on, and some tips on how to optimize our morning. If this is something you're interested in, then keep on watching. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jeanne, Agius, your self-care coach. This is the channel dedicated to prioritizing self-care in every aspect of our life so that we can be the best version of ourselves. If you guys are new, a warm welcome to you guys all. Please consider subscribing as I do provide practical tips on how to prioritize self-care so that we can live a guilt-free life that we love. So without further ado, I'm gonna get into this week's video where I'm talking about the 5 a.m. club and how to master our morning and optimize it so that we get the most done and start our day on the right foot. Waking up at 5 a.m. is one of the most powerful habits in my life that has been in my life before I even became a mom. I have been doing it for probably over a decade now, and I have been seeing the value of it, and it's probably why I'm able to be as productive and efficient as possible in my life and where I find I get the most things done. The benefits of waking up early is endless, and just to name a few, we tend to feel like we have more control over our lives. If we are more proactive versus reactive, we control what we need to do throughout the day by making sure that we have everything scheduled and we reverse engineer our goals. We basically have the end in mind. What is it that we want to accomplish that day? What do we need to achieve? And therefore, we need to wake up at a certain amount of time in order to get it done. And that is our why. So finding out your why and why you want to wake up early, what you need to get done, is a powerful reason to actually get you up. And once you are up, remind yourself of the benefits. Try it for 30 days. It's life-changing. And I have been doing it every single day and into me being pregnant with both of my babies and now being on mat leave, I still continue waking up early in the morning because that is my golden window of opportunity to master my movement, my mindfulness, and also my mastery. So let's get into those three things and take a deeper dive into each one of them. Let's take a deeper dive into movement. So exercising in the morning as the first thing that I do in the morning has been very life-changing as well. I've been doing this for as long as I can remember, and the benefits are endless. You sleep better at night, you're able to really conquer your day and really have a higher metabolism in the morning because the first thing that you do is you're working out, so it's really kickstarting your day. The likelihood of you eating and making healthier choices throughout the day because you started it on the right foot. In the morning, your testosterone level is also higher, which helps you with increasing your muscle mass. It's important to schedule it in, implement it into your morning schedule so it doesn't get put off the rest of the day with other scheduling conflicts, and you make sure that you build it into a habit. You can start off by 20 minutes, half an hour, build it up to 45 minutes. But waking up in the morning and finding opportunities to move, get it done, out of the way, kickstart your day is pivotal to mastering your morning routine. Next, I'm gonna talk about mindfulness and having time in the morning to connect with yourself, with your purpose, with your higher power is absolutely transformative and magical. Most people would normally wake up really busy and overwhelmed, thinking about all the responsibilities they have in front of them. But if you wake up with intention, it becomes really inspiring and powerful. When you have alone time to listen to your inner voice and your intuition and really connecting with what you feel grateful about. So for example, writing in your gratitude journal, thinking about three things that you are grateful for, even thinking about three things the day before that you experienced that was a win for you. Thinking about all these positive things really sets your day up for success because you're coming at it with a very positive mind frame in a better headspace to tackle anything. Now, the downfall of not doing this is that you're living unconsciously throughout your life and you're kind of repeating the same thing that you did yesterday. And so that aren't working in your favor just happens over and over again. But if you are consciously living, then you are actually working towards your goals, your dreams, you're doing things to really move the needle and be closer to what you want to achieve in life. When you're living with mindfulness, you can happen to the world versus the world happening to you. And lastly, mastery. That is when you work on professional development and personal development. So I actually sometimes merge the two, and when I'm working out, I will put on a podcast, something on YouTube that is empowering, and it gives me hope for my future, and it gives me motivation to actually move the needle. So what's something that you're trying to achieve? Is it to read more, to learn more, to do more, to be more? All those things will help you, and the only way that you're able to get that alone is early in the morning. So whether that be reading a chapter, 20 pages, a book by the end of the week, really ask yourself, going back to what I mentioned in the first part, what's your why? When you learn more, it's an invaluable skill to read. So when you learn more, you're able to make better decisions, be more motivated, be more confident, feel more competent. There's so many things that we can do in the morning to improve mastery. And I love this part of my morning because I'm able to get in 25 pages every single day. And it's actually something that my husband started doing and I started doing as well, because I would say that reading is probably one of the things that I put off. And now I wake up in the morning with intention and I make sure to make time to master my skills. So if there's endless amount of books by wonderful authors that I want to read, they are pretty much shortcutting your learning curve for things that you want to learn. So figuring out, what do you want to improve on? Like, what do you want in life? What do you want to improve on? And how are you going to get there? And by getting there, reading a lot of books and learning and working on personal and professional development is your key to improving your mastery in your life. And that's how you optimize your morning. Well, we are nearing the end of our video, but I want to leave you guys with three other bonus tips that I incorporate in the morning to make sure that I move towards movement, mindfulness, and mastery. And the first thing is, I make sure that I don't look at my phone right away when I wake up. That way I'm able to be efficient and I'm not consuming other people's content. The second one is, I make sure that I consume a big glass of water to kickstart my metabolism and to really cleanse and detox my body. And the last thing is, I make sure that I have a schedule for the morning, because if I'm going to be waking up so early in the morning, I have to make sure that I know exactly what I'm doing. And there you have it. Those are my three things. I hope that you guys found value in this video. And if you guys are considering joining the 5 a.m. club, I hope that I'm able to kind of push you over to that group and really incorporate it as a powerful habit. Because for me, it has been a ripple effect and it has changed my life. And I hope that you guys will consider doing that too. I hope that you guys like this video and leave a comment below. Let me know, are you part of the 5 a.m. club? And if not, what's stopping you from doing so? Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. I would love for you guys to join my tribe. And also, if you guys are interested in working with me on how you become the best version of yourself, all the information is down below in the description. Thank you so much for watching. You guys know how much I appreciate each and every one of you. Please come back and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye for now.